What's up, guys? It is I, once again, MR.GAMER, and welcome to another part of our Let's Play series on Mass Effect 2, and let's continue where we last left off and resume game right now and check our messages, and we shall have some chit-chats with our squad mates. Messages, okay, and what the fuck?
Steven Hack at Alliance HQ.
Commander Shepard,
okay.
I need to discuss a sensitive matter with you privately.
I'll take this in my quarters.
Yeah. Sure. Hackett. Admiral Hackett. Interesting. Let's hear from the old man, guys and girls. It should be indeed interesting. Yeah.
Commander, thank you for your time. I'll keep this brief. We have a deep cover operative out in Batarian space. Name's Dr. Amanda Kenson. Dr. Kenson recently reported that she found evidence of an imminent Reaper invasion.
So why call me?
Just this morning I received word that the Batarians arrested her. They're holding her in a secret prison outpost on terrorism charges. I need you to infiltrate the prison and get her out of there. As a favor to me, I'm asking you to go in alone.
DLC, arrival, solo mission.
I have a hell of a squad with me. I'm sure they'd help out.
Kenson is my friend. If the Batarians see a squad of armed soldiers, they'll kill her. This is serious, Commander. Go in with discretion, or don't go at all.
What is Dr. Kenson actually doing out there?
She's a deep cover operative, Shepard. We talk only when we have to. I'd heard she was investigating a rumor of a Reaper artifact in the system. Her last report said she'd found it.
What else can you tell me about the operative?
Amanda's a top scientist and an Alliance agent working in Batarian space. It's a deadly assignment, and she's one of the few up to the challenge. She and I go back pretty far, Commander. I won't let her rot away in a Batarian torture camp.
I thought the Alliance denies the Reaper threat. That must be some proof she found.
Kenson's team found an artifact out in Batarian space. She believes it's a Reaper device, proof that the Reapers are indeed planning to invade. I've known her a long time. If she says she has proof, it's worth checking out.
The Batarians won't take kindly to the Alliance breaking into a secret prison.
This is not an Alliance operation. It's one person going in alone to save a friend. If it were an official mission, of course the Batarians would be upset. You keep this quiet, Shepard, and there's nothing to worry about.
If I have time, I'll save her. Yeah.
I'll make this a priority.
The prison is hidden underground at a Batarian outpost in Araton. I'll upload the coordinates now. Once she's secure, confirm her discovery. We'll debrief you when you're back.
Got it.
Hack it now.
Okay. What the fuck? Thank God, guys and girls, we don't have to do it right now, because that DLC, guys and girls, is quite difficult. Very difficult indeed, and we're going to talk to Miranda Lawson right now. We're going to talk to her, and of course, Jacob Taylor, and then Jack. Subject Zero, My Bay, after Dr. Liara DeSony. Yeah, guys and girls, I love them both. And what the fuck? Wrong room. Yeah, of course. We're going to see her right now, in the cruise quarters. Cruise. But yeah, let's go there and talk to Miranda. Ms. Lawson, some news stories from these guys. One guy
Another
and one girl.
Missing.
Ferris Fields, I heard. That's not far from New Canton. Did your family get back to Earth?
Not yet. My mother-in-law's given us grief. Operative Lawson assures me the transport team will physically drag them away if need be.
Of course. Talk to Ms. Lawson right now. Miranda's office, okay, and talk to Miranda Lawson.
Shepard, I find myself in the unpleasant position of asking for your help. I don't like discussing personal matters, but this is important.
Miranda, you're one of my crew. Tell me what's on your mind.
You remember what I told you about Father building a dynasty? There was another reason I went to Cerberus for protection.
Do tell.
I have a sister, a twin, and he's still hunting her. Cerberus has kept her safe, until now. She's living a normal life on Ilium, safe and hidden from my father.
So you think your father has tracked her down?
Precisely, Commander. My sources indicate he knows that she's on Ilium. I've tried to keep her hidden without impacting her life, but I'm out of options.
Oriana, her sister.
He's too close. I need to relocate my sister's family before it's too late.
What do you know about your sister?
She's my genetic twin. We're identical, but she deserves a normal life, and she's going to get it no matter what.
Does your sister's family know about this? Are they okay with being relocated?
They know nothing. They're completely uninvolved. Normal. I told Cerberus, and they're coming up with a positive reason to move the family.
What do you need me to do?
My father is extremely persistent. I'd like to go to Ilium when Cerberus is moving the family to make sure none of his agents get too close.
Yeah.
My contact's name is Lantea. She'll be waiting for us in the lounge near the Nos Astra docking bay.
Sure thing. The Cerberus cheerleader wants our help. Sorry, guys and girls, but yeah, the cheerleader wants our help to help her sister, you know? And let's talk to Garrus Vakarian.
Need me for something?
Yeah.
You got a minute?
Calibrations.
I'm in the middle of some calibrations.
Jesus, this guy
you
and his calibrations.
Got any upgrade ideas for these weapon systems?
My current upgrades are working pretty well. That's about
Thank
the
you.
Best I can do.
Yeah.
Talk to you later, Garrus.
Get back
I'll
to your calibrations. Sure thing, Garrus. Garrus and his fucking calibrations. Calibrations. My fucking ass. Let's go talk to Jack right now. In Deck 4, Engineering. And then Jacob Taylor. Calibrations, though. I'm sorry, guys and girls, but that's fucking stupid. Garrus and his calibrations. Go talk to Jack right here. Subject 0, my bay, after Liara. Dr. Liara Tassoni, and talk to her.
Hey.
Tell me about you, Jack. What are you up to?
Still checking out your ship. Wouldn't mind putting her through her paces when you're not around.
If I take you too seriously, I might need to deal with you.
Try it. Anyway, joyriding doesn't have the thrill it used to. Besides, if I wanted it, I'd take it.
That's so.
I did not
I've been
do
around.
That.
Ran with gangs.
I did not.
Some gangs, joined a cult. Kept the haircut. I learned how to survive and not be a victim.
It's hard to imagine you in a cult. That usually involves a lot of rules.
I was looking for answers. Drugs and sex and going to a better place.
Of course.
A better place. Right. It was all about money. They wanted to take a colony, shake the suckers down to fund their spread, and guess who was their ace in the... They were just like the rest. Didn't
ace
give
in
one
the
shit about me.
But
what
yeah.
did you do when you found out?
I know how she feels. I do. You don't trust anyone.
You
who
must
does?
Listen to good people, too.
I don't.
Everybody wants something. And because of that, everything is fair. Murder,
fair
assault, kidnapping, drugs, stealing, arson. Done it all. And that's the boring shit. Piracy, theft of military craft, destruction of a space station, and vandalism. That was a good one.
Military's a hard target. Bet
Guys.
That made you some friends.
I'm not skipping
Shouldn't
anything.
Have left the thing unlocked. Besides,
Weird.
Parades are boring. I have
a space station.
The fuck?
You're pushing what
Guys.
I can believe.
Glitches.
Ain't saying it was easy. Not everything is spur of the moment. Sometimes you gotta work to give people what they deserve. Had some people I hung with for a while. Outlaw colony. Felt like they were like me. Guess that made us a nice Tartarians think they know something
the
about
fuck?
A scorched earth response. Fuck 'em.
Okay.
You were a pirate
yeah.
too?
Ties in with the kidnapping. If you hijack a passenger ship and don't kill everyone, anyway. Good lesson. Simpler to just kill them all.
I'm surprised you'd even mention vandalism in that bunch.
That's what the Hanar call it when you crash that space station I mentioned into one of their moons and make a new... They really liked that moon.
Yeah,
you ever wonder
sure.
if you could have done things differently?
No.
Shouldn't you?
There's no reason I should be alive, but I am. You know why? Instinct. It's worked for me so far, and I'm not gonna change.
Yeah, of course.
Hey, Shepard. No one's ever asked me about this shit. It's strange to talk about. So fuck
you.
And thanks for asking.
Anytime. And fuck you too. Psychotic, biotic bitch who yours truly loves. I do, guys and girls. I fucking do. Talk to these clowns
Garrus
right
put
here.
Some crazy take into them. You're the best, Commander. We just got those FBA couplings installed. Now we only have to calibrate every week instead of every day. We're thinking about celebrating our newfound free time with some Skillion 5 poker. Want to join us?
Come on, Kenneth. The Commander doesn't want to play cards with grease monkeys like us.
Actually, that sounds interesting.
Fantastic. I'll
Go
get the cards.
Go easy on the new guy. Remember, I'm your boss. Go easy on the new guy.
My Skillion 5's a bit rusty. You'll be easy on the rookie, right?
Of course, Commander. It's all friendly.
Yeah, right.
here, friendly. Shepard is a con artist. He is 500 credits. Goddamn, guys and girls. Shepard is a...
I can't believe he fell for that.
Fucking con artist.
You've taken down a notch.
Yeah. Yeah, back at you, bro. And sis. But yeah, guys and girls, Shepard is a hustler and con artist, and let's go talk to Jacob Taylor. Shepard, man. Shepard. Can we talk to Morden Solace too? I wonder. Let's talk to Jacob first before Morden Solace. Jacob, you want to chat?
Commander, sorry I'm a little unfocused. Personal matter. It won't affect my duties.
The yeoman said you wanted to see me. What's this about, Jacob?
As I said, it's a personal matter. I don't want to waste our time if it turns out to be a goose chase. But...
Your father?
Well, I got pinged by a ghost the other night. Family.
I'm listening.
My private log got an update about the Hugo Gernsback, the ship my father served on. It sent an SOS last week, reporting a crash and requesting a rescue. Shepard, that ship went missing 10 years ago. I hadn't talked to my father for 3 years before that. I've buried everything but a body. I'm not convinced it isn't just some automated distress signal ticking over. It's been too long.
I think you'd be more excited that your father might be alive.
He wasn't around enough for me to have bad memories. It's an old, well-healed wound. But if he's actually alive and needs help, I also want to note that it's not normal procedure for distress calls to be routed to the Normandy. This was passed to my personal log through Cerberus filters.
Any signs that this was a Cerberus front? Who passed this to you?
I doubt the elusive man would let a direct operation stake hold this long. If there's a link, it's probably just about money. Cerberus needs diverse holdings to fund projects like, well, you.
Thank you.
And whoever sent this my way covered their tracks. Someone could be fishing for favors, or thought it would get under my skin. Who knows with that bunch?
You didn't get along with your father?
He made no apologies, I'll give him that. You make a mistake, you own up to it. Even if you keep making it.
That's what,
whatever
men
problems
do.
We had were a lifetime ago. I've had 10 years to get to where I am. And as far as I know, he's still a ghost.
Tell me about the Hugo Gernsback and what it was doing.
Privately held frigate. I looked over the mission brief when it disappeared. Nothing stood out. Typical research and grab operation. Find an uncharted planet, stake a claim, and establish as large a presence as you can as fast as possible to shut out competitors.
I think we can spare the time. Pass the coordinates to Joker.
I appreciate that, Commander. I don't expect more than dusty old bones, but it'll be good to close the record.
Yeah, of course. Let's go talk to Morden Solace right now. Dr. Morden Solace. Hello, Morden. Do you want
Shepard,
to chat?
How can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Yes, would like that, actually. Talked about work earlier. Time with special tasks group studying genophage. It wasn't entirely honest. Lie of omission. Also, other kinds. Need to clear the air. Mission too important to keep secrets. Work on genophage was more than just study.
What was the special task group doing with the Krogan genophage?
Study at first, as I said, but uncovered surprising data. Krogan population was increasing at faster rate than expected. Krogan were adapting to genophage. Overcoming disease.
Did the Krogan evolve, or did some of their scientists develop a treatment?
Krogan scientists? Never met Krogan scientist worthy of term. No. Natural evolution. Krogan physiology incredibly durable. Organ redundancy, backup systems, cellular regeneration. Genophage like any other natural hazard. Krogan evolved past it.
Maybe they were just having a lucky year. Or fewer mercs left, meaning more Krogan were left to repopulate.
Please, Shepard. Social environmental concerns accounted for. Not an undergraduate. Population spike caused by adaptation to genophage. No other possibility.
The genophage was a terrible mistake. It nearly destroyed the Krogan and their culture. Now they have a chance to recover.
Naive viewpoint. Krogan too dangerous to allow unchecked birth rate. Look at Krogan rebellions. Personally led a science team. Geneticists, chemists, sociologists, mathematicians. Created new version of genophage, released it onto Chanka, other Krogan-centric areas, re-stabilized Krogan population.
On both sides, this was the best choice. How so? Distribution of virus.
How did you distribute the modified genophage?
Covert drops, hospitals, clan centers, water supplies. Very difficult. Few Solarians onto Chanka. Team got caught a few times. Had to fight free. messy. Better when things went as planned.
How did your genophage modification work?
Krogan evolution attached garbage genetic code to genophage attack sites. Modification created areas for garbage code to connect. Left sites clean, capable, running smoothly.
You never considered other options?
Hundreds. Thousands. Modified genophage offered best outcome. Stabilized population, avoided publicity that could incite Krogan anger, averted potential genocide, or devastating war. Best solution for whole galaxy. Krogan included.
If the Krogan are so dangerous, why not just sterilize them outright?
Not a war criminal. Not a murderer. Genocide unnecessary. Krogan as a whole, violent, aggressive, still have outliers, worth saving. Genophage modification protected galaxy, allowed Krogan chance to survive. Everyone wins. Good for us, good for them.
The genophage was a mistake bordering on a war crime. Recreating it is unforgivable.
Don't want me on team? Don't bring me. Can stay here, work on collector research. But no apologies. Did what was right. Hope you do the same if necessary. Should get back to work.
Sure.
Talk more later. Next time, tissue synthesis has to compile. Good for free time.
Okay. Wow. Quite a discussion, or debate, rather. And let's talk to Joker and his new partner, Edie.
So, Hadley, how are you going to spend your next furlough?
You really
co-pilot, actually.
Of course. Shepard's and forming the best team this galaxy has ever seen. We're getting chicks in the ass.
Sure you're right. We are. Joker, Edie, how are you guys doing? Guy and girl. But yeah.
Hey, Commander. It's, pretty crazy the people you can run into out here, huh? I mean, it was probably a setup or something, but it was still good to see Caden. Staff Commander Malenko, wasn't it?
Barely.
He moved on. I can't blame him.
He was frontline with you against a Reaper, and I'm the one who gets roped back into saving the galaxy? Did someone switch our files?
You're the force that pulls it all together, Joker.
Force.
I'll give you that.
Wow. Jesus. The fucking force. Jar Jar Binks, the force. My god, guys and girls. I love Jar Jar Binks, I do. How are things in the cockpit?
I assume everything is going well up
but
here.
Yeah.
We're just having an argument over personalization of my workspace.
Cerberus regulations are clear, Mr. Moreau. Personalization does not include grease on my bridge cameras.
It's just mad that all its footage of me looks like a dream sequence.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
See you.
You see me again!
I'm sorry, guys and girls. I could not help but quote Jar Jar Binks. Fucking Jar Jar Binks, man. Let's go to the planet right now and help out Jacob's father. Jacob Taylor's father on the planet we are going to right now. Help Jacob. Of course, guys and girls. Of course. It should be fun. Yeah, helping out Jacob, you know. And where do we go right now to help out Jacob? This way, I think. Alpha Draconis. And which planet? 2175 Aia. What the fuck kind of name is that? Aia. Of course you do, Edie.
Stress. MSV Hugo Gernsback. Registration BW46100.
I have found something.
Interesting. Thank you, Edie. And we're going to land right now and help out Jacob's father. We're going to take Jacob and, of course, Miranda Lawson. Jacob is a must. And Miranda, I just love her. Miranda Lawson, baby. Oh, yeah. Except. Okay. 4. Cool. Combat mastery. To the max, guys and gals. To the max. Shock Trooper or Commando. Let's go with Shock Trooper, guys and gals. Plus 100% Paragon and Renegade. Oh, yeah, baby. Maybe. Fuck yeah. Miranda Lawson and Jacob. Cerberus operative. Okay, sure. And Miranda. 3-4 warp. Why not? And let's go, guys and girls. Exit. Okay. And we're going to help out Jacob's dad in this island. Beautiful island. Which is likely hostile. Oh yeah. It's to be expected. Okay, let's go.
I have run a scan of the ship. I detect no life signs, but there may be useful technology or information still inside.
Thank you, Edie. Thank you very much. My god, this island is so beautiful. It really is, guys and gals. Look at that view. God damn, baby. This island, man. So beautiful, but let's go this way and see what we can do.
There it is, and mostly intact. It could have survived impact.
Yeah, of course.
Looks like it was
what the fuck
crash.
Is that?
They'd have tried to get a beacon up as soon as possible.
Some kind of VI. Okay, activate the beacon.
Danger of rapid neural decay.
local flora chemically incompatible with human physiology.
From the look of it, this beacon's been here a while. Why would they wait years to signal?
Pause in beacon protocol. 8 years, 237 days, 7 hours. Pause is recorded as record deleted by acting captain Ronald Taylor.
That's not right. My father was first officer.
Ronald Taylor was promoted under emergency command protocols. Other flagged issues: unsafe deceleration, local food and neural decay, beacon activation protocols.
Who's in command of this ship? Where are the survivors?
Captain Harris Fairchild reported killed following unscheduled suborbital descent. First Officer Ronald Taylor promoted infield to acting captain.
But where is he now?
The location of the remaining crew of the Hugo Gernsback is unknown. This beacon has been unattended for several maintenance cycles.
I assume unsafe deceleration refers to the crash. Give me the details.
Following an unspecified impact and sublight drive failure, the Hugo Gernsback made an unscheduled descent at 465% of theoretical recommended suborbital velocity. The Hugo Gernsback then decelerated at 782% of theoretical recommended approach velocity, sustaining significant damage to investment and crew.
Local food impairs brain functions? What are the effects?
Impairment of mental function due to chemical imbalance begins within 7 days of ingesting local flora, regardless of decontamination or preparation. Impact on higher cognitive abilities and long-term memory is cumulative, but significant within a standard month. It is not known if neural decay is permanent. Data collection was not completed.
Why wasn't the beacon activated before now?
This emergency beacon became functional after 358 days, 12 hours. Following the unscheduled suborbital descent of the Hugo Gernsback, activation was triggered remotely after 8 years, 237 days, 7 hours, on the authority of acting captain Ronald Taylor. Pause in beacon protocol is recorded as record deleted.
Come on, let's get going.
Let's check the ship.
This way.
My father
indeed
had the beacon for almost 9 years. Maybe that neural decay affected it.
Okay, what the fuck?
We've done horrible things to the crew. The conditions they're in, they don't understand what we're doing to them. Distract them for 2 seconds and they forget what you did before the bruises show. It's got to stop. I'm talking to the others as soon as...
Whoa, what the fuck happened? No idea, but let's find out some more info inside the ship, shall we, guys and girls? But man, look at this ship. It's quite big. Oh yeah. And crash. Hack? Okay. Let's do it, guys and girls. Let's do it. 1, 2, and last but not least. Yeah, guys and girls, we did it. 3,000 credits. Thank you. And log. Second log.
Fairchild knew this crew. His replacement doesn't command the same level of respect. I'm hoping the man has it in him.
Whoa, what the fuck happened? I wonder. Another log? Okay, number 3. Yeah, of course. They've given up, guys and girls. And the last log, number 4.
What was her name? Sarah? Suzanne? My god, I can't remember. I can't remember her face. We need to get out so I can remember, can think straight. They have to hurry.
Okay, something happened here. Something big and bad. Let's find out what that big and bad thing is. Up ahead, guys and girls. Let's go. Okay, anyone here? Yodelehihu. Oh.
You came from the sky? The leader said someone would come. He delayed so long, but he still has power. Some have lost faith. The hunters. They will have seen your star. They will not let you help him.
What are you talking about? You're not making sense.
I don't remember how to say it. He's our leader and we serve so we can go home. But
Ronald.
Some want to fight him. They were cast out.
Ronald Taylor.
So they hunt his machines and those
behind you.
they don't believe that
Watch out. Thank God.
Hunters,
we saved her.
The leader is dead.
Kill them, agents of the liar. He will not.
Let's kill them, guys and girls. Fuck these bitches. Yeah, kill them right now. Use a pull. Okay, pull field and shoot. Put that cocksucker down. Wait. Get up right now. Get up and shoot, baby. Shoot. Fuck you, bitch. Get the fuck down right now. Hello there, bitch. Put his asshole in the face. Okay, good. Use a pull field. Okay, and shoot. Come on, get the fuck up. And shoot, baby. Shoot. Get closer right now, and what the fuck? Hello there. We have someone here. A guest. Unwelcome guest. The headshot. Headshot, baby. Bingo. And fuck you, asshole. Whoa. Use a warp. We can't, so let's use a pull. We can't do that either. So let's go over here and use a slow motion thing, like so, and shoot. Fuck that asshole. And use a warp there. We can, and thank you, and fuck you. Bingo.
That wasn't neural decay. They were feral.
No.
My father wouldn't let this go on. Something is very wrong.
Very, indeed. And talk to her.
You killed them, but there are more every day. They want to fight.
I'm sure.
But I just want to go home.
She's we need to find someone who can make sense of this.
Sure thing. Jacob Taylor. Ronald Taylor's son. Quite ironic, guys and girls. And what's this?
Tech's wearing out. Those hunters must be laying under pressure.
Indeed. Let's go this way and be careful. Extra careful.
Is that a settlement? They better be friendlier than the beach group. I need answers.
Okay, sure thing. Calm down, Jacob. Calm down. Go this way and talk to them. And see what they know.
They're clearly docile, but in the same uniform remnants as those who attacked us.
There aren't any men here. Maybe it affects genders differently. Makes males get violent.
Huh. Who
Possibly.
Knows?
But the woman on the beach said the exiled ones came back as hunters.
It doesn't matter right now. One of these people must know what my father has to do with this.
You have his face. He promised to call the sky, but he sends nothing.
He forced us to eat. To decay. You are cursed with his face.
Something you said, Jacob. That's not a good sign. Something you said, Jacob.
You certainly seem to have a way with words.
You heard her.
Yeah.
I have his face. My father forced the crew to eat toxic food. What the hell?
Indeed. That's fucked up, but let's talk to him.
I don't want to punish him.
It's fine. Don't worry, honey. Don't worry at all. And what do we have here? Some more survivors. Let's find something useful, like a PDA. Okay. What the fuck? Whoa. Kill those motherfuckers. Use a overload. Heavy overload. Okay. Be careful. And that's it. Yeah.
Maybe it was just for defense.
Who knows? And talk to the doctor.
Here.
Right here.
You could end it.
Okay. Sure.
Have his face. But you fight his machines. You might stop this. This, I forget how to read. But this was the start. What he promised and what they did to us.
Yeah.
We need the sky. Take us back to the sky.
Wow, we're waiting. What is it?
Jacob, what does it say?
It's a crew logbook. Some of them thought the beacon repair was taking too long. They were afraid they'd run out of supplies and lose their minds to the decay. My father restricted the ship food for himself and the other officers so they wouldn't be affected.
Wow.
Everybody else had to eat the toxic food and hope for treatment later. The rest is a casualty list. A few mutinied over the decision. My father and his officers turned the mechs on them.
It wasn't command material, and it got to him. Couldn't keep the crew in line without violence.
It didn't stop there. More incidents, harsh punishments. It's like they're cattle or toys. In a year, all the male crew members are flagged as exiled or dead. They separated out the women, assigned them to officers like pets. And after the beacon is fixed, the officers appear in the casualties too.
Motherfucker.
My father took control and didn't stop it.
Anything in there about whether the effects of the toxic food can be treated?
Nothing. But it seems like the right call. If everyone gets it, who's left to fix the beacon? You'd never get out. But they did fix it. And the signal wasn't sent until now. I'm starting to see why.
Does it say why he separated the men and the women? Or is it as bad as it seems?
No, it turns to gibberish.
Maybe the men got violent early on, but from the state of this place, I'd say the Hunter thing is recent. What he allowed here, Shepard? I don't see any justification.
We haven't seen any other officers. He killed them?
There were five after the crash. Medical, engineering, bridge staff. Should have had no problem fixing the beacon and keeping people safe. All killed within the same week. About a month after the beacon was repaired.
Do you see an explanation for this? He's your father.
Is he? None of this fits. Maybe the initial decision, but the rest? Abuse of power doesn't get any clearer than this. I need to find this man.
Yeah, of course. We're going to Jacob. We're going to indeed. Set the bomb, okay. Bypass, yeah. Let's do it, guys and girls. Last one and bingo. Back off right now. Now, 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 my god. Jesus. Fuck me. That bomb went off.
This is Captain Ronald Taylor. Thank god you're here. My crew went insane. I only just got free.
Huh.
Yeah.
Just got free. He's covering his ass.
Indeed.
The old corpse has been posed, like a warning. The new ones were left where they fell.
The Hunters started fighting back.
They did. And let's go this way, guys and girls. And be ready to fight right now. Shoot, 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 shoot. Fuck these motherfuckers. Okay, who's next? Use a warp. Overload, actually, and shoot, shoot, shoot. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Come on. Shoot, shoot, fuck you. Pick up some ammo here. Good. Over there. Shoot, shoot. Come on, good. And this one too. Fuck you, bitch. Fuck you and die. Who's next? Oh my god, plenty. Plenty are next. And shoot them, fuck you, asshole. Duck, okay. Full field. And shoot, shoot, shoot. Come on, good. Fuck you, bitch. Up right now. Come on, come on. And shoot right there. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Fight! Like that, baby, like that. And shoot again, like that, baby. Yeah. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Fuck you, assholes. Fuck you. And fight. Good, yeah, of course. Come on, shoot, shoot, pull. And shoot, shoot, shoot. This way too. Wait, wait. And fire now! Good! Fuck you, bitch! Plenty are dead.
I keep them busy, distracted, but it's getting dangerous.
Of course.
He had his fun. Now he wants out.
Yeah, son of a bitch indeed. Scan, heavy pistol, goddamn. Oh yeah, guys and girls. That's good, very good. Let's find the sucker and end him. Oh yeah, guys and girls, we shall end him, that is. And shoot, shoot right now. Shoot those bitches there. Shoot, shoot, come on, fuck these assholes. Wait, wait, and use the overload. Overload right now and shoot, baby, shoot. Okay, move forward right now. And shoot, baby, fuck me, I missed. Sorry, guys and girls, I will not miss again. Not again. And fuck you bitches, yeah. I did not miss this time. And what the fuck? Jacob is dead and now he's back. Good. Yeah, bring it.
This thing is not my father.
Uh-huh. We got some credits and some ammos. Thank you very much. Reload right now and pick up some more ammos. And move, 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 and kill, kill, kill. Shoot those bitches. These guys right here. Okay. Shoot, shoot, shoot. Overload there and fire. Come on, come on, come on. Fire. And what the fuck is this? Whoa, combat drone, okay? Go home? I don't think so. What the fuck? I'm next. God damn it. Back off right now. Wait, Jacob, don't move forward. Jacob, god damn it. Overload right now, Miranda. And shoot, 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 shoot. Back off, back off, back off. Miranda, Jacob, this way. Fuck me. Jacob is dead. Double fuck me, guys and girls. You will pay, Mac. You will pay and die. Die, bitch. Kaboom. Oh, yeah. What the fuck? Hello over there, sexy. Shoot him down. And this one, too. The sexy motherfucker. Shoot, shoot. Fuck you, asshole. Fuck you.
Enough with the toys.
Yeah.
Father in the eye here, justify this.
Yeah, you will. He shall, guys and girls. Let's access the door right here, and thank you. Okay, there's Ronald Taylor, Jacob's father. Let's talk to him, guys and girls. Jacob's daddy, big daddy, his loser of a
You're
dad.
Here. I knew a real squad would blow through just fine. Sorry if the mech scuffed your pants.
Huh.
I'll get you something nice when we get back to Alliance space. Gotta have some back pay coming.
What about your crew, acting captain?
Total loss. Toxic food turned them wild. They propped me up here in some kind of ritual behavior. Waiting for a chance to signal has been hell.
That's the best you can do?
You let all your people talk back like that? Who are you exactly?
Dave Fennoy, the actor of Ronald Taylor.
Of the Normandy. I believe you're acquainted with Mr. Taylor.
Yeah. Taylor? Jacob? No. Not Jacob.
Why not me? Would 10 years of this look better to anyone else in the galaxy?
You have to understand, this isn't me. The realities of command, they change you. I wasn't ready for that. I made sure you were taught right. Before I left, I hoped to leave it at that.
I'm not biting, Captain. At some point, you chose to do this to your crew. You.
What was that moment? I want to know that there was an actual reason.
Whoa.
There was resistance to the plan. Mutiny. We had to take a hard line to keep order. And things settled down. As the decay set in, we made sure the crew were comfortable. Some even seemed happier. Ignorance is bliss, right? And they were grateful for guidance, like an instinct. Pure authority was easy at first. Months in, the effect lowered inhibitions. They got territorial. Rank, protocol, they couldn't understand. We had to establish dominance. After a while, the perks seemed normal.
That's it? You created a harem and played king? 10 years in a juvenile fantasy?
I can't point to where it all went wrong. But when the beacon was ready, revealing what happened didn't seem like a good idea.
What happened to the other officers?
Anders found his conscience a little late to step back. He had an accident. Things got tense. End of the day, I was the one with the mix. I got a little basic in setting examples. But I was kind to my people once things settled down. Seemed like I'd earned some peace.
You fought over people like they were toys. Things.
The stores from the ship couldn't last forever. You had to know this would end one day.
Dining for one can really stretch things out. Besides, I can think of a lot worse retirement plans than stripping down and joining the droolers. That was before the hunters, of course. Dumb or not, I'd feel it if they got their hands on me now. They want blood. I'd prefer to keep it.
It's all about you. Everything.
You didn't feel any responsibility to get out of here for the sake of family?
I gave him a good start. He was a smart kid and was better off not following me.
Wow.
We figured that out a long time before I took jobs in deep space. And after things escalated here, it seemed best to just disappear off the galactic map.
Till you need someone to save your ass.
Then my dad.
What triggered the males to change and threaten?
Yes. Far worse.
This planet has some strange cycles to it. I've seen some plants around I never saw before. Odd weather. Maybe some just adapted a little too well.
And if you treat them like animals, big shock. They become animals.
We can help these people. Cerberus can have ships here in days and pull everyone out.
He's not worth the fuel to haul him out or the air he's breathing.
Whoa.
He's damn lucky I don't think he's even worth pulling the trigger. I don't know who you are. Because you're not any father I remember.
You can't escape the law, right?
We'll secure him for an alliance court. For every year here, he'll have 10 to think about it.
Give him all the time in the galaxy. The man who did this doesn't know right from wrong.
I'm sorry, Jacob. I did the best I could.
I'm 10 years past believing that.
Yeah. Right now, only actions can speak louder than words. But yeah, Ronald Taylor and mission accomplished, guys and gals. We helped out Jacob and the mission was a huge success because of it. And close report right now. And we shall talk with Jacob. Jacob Taylor and the Cerberus team is always awesome. It is. The Alliance is good, but Cerberus are awesome. Damn right. Jacob Taylor.
Alliance ships are inbound to secure Captain Taylor as crew commander. We'll be long gone by the time they get here.
Good job.
Don't even give them the taillights.
Roger that.
Mm-hmm. Indeed. Jacob.
What do you mean it wasn't you?
Jacob, if I had leaked the information about the Gurns back, I would be smiling at your resolution of the situation.
Still toying with us, but you knew about it.
Nothing goes through this ship, my ship, without a report to you.
I had no more reason to believe Jacob's father was alive than he did. But I'm happy to know the situation is behind you.
Fine. You didn't forward it. So who did?
I did.
To help or mess with him? The obvious insider. Yeah, to help or mess with him.
Or did you just want to see him squirm?
What he did with it was his own business. There was a time when it mattered to you. Sending this along seemed like keeping an old promise. I keep my promises.
Miranda, we'll discuss your liberal interpretation of security protocol in private.
Liberal
Jacob.
Interpretation. there's some history between them and some complexity in their relationship. You all right?
You good with this, Jacob?
It's all bull, Shepard. Captain Taylor can rot in prison. Doesn't change who I am or what I know. I've already mourned the man he used to be. I guess he was a good enough father that even he can't screw up what he taught me.
You had no idea Miranda was behind this?
No, she's got a good memory. Selective, but good. I haven't thought about those days in a long time. Can't figure which promise she meant, though. Not sure I really want to know. She requires a better man than I.
Really?
Come on. We've got work to do.
I can.
You're talking about Shepard, even though Shepard is taken.
Thanks for the help.
With Liara. You're welcome.
Anytime, Jim.
Brother. Yeah, anytime. Be seeing you, brother. And we're going to end the episode right here, guys and girls. Thank you all so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, comment, subscribe if you wish, and look forward to another part of our Let's Play series on Mass Effect 2. Until next time, peace out, take care, adios, amigos, au revoir, and sayonara.